starting the inaugural episode of Let's Embrace with a very good friend of mine, Kimberly Van Schoyck. She and her partner Rebecca started an eyewear brand called Yunizon. The brand captures core values of free expression, unity, and belonging. These are the principles they strive to promote through their brand, their product, and their actions. And I felt that it was really timely. They started their brand almost 2 years ago, but being that things are extremely volatile these days and we are finally facing some big challenges that have been part of American society, I thought it'd be really lovely to connect with her and speak about the brand that upholds really high standards.
I know it's I know it's 1:30, but you know, should you need one, go ahead.
I mean, I don't see why not. And the liquor, the wine is like right here.
I mean, well, cheers. So obviously I wanted to ask you, how are you doing? But pandemic and now the protests that we've had in the city, it's been a quite intense 100 days here. Like, tell me how you are.
So, you know, it's like, I feel like with everything that's been going on with the Black Lives Matter movement, it kind of changed everything from the pandemic where we were all scared about ourselves and our immediate family to kind of taking care of everyone as a whole, which, you know, there's no good time for things to happen, but it kind of feels right. I think in the end, like, this is like the silver lining to Trump as a president and like this pandemic.
This is an impetus for change versus like what we've been feeling like a potential re-election and we were all in trepidation and it seems as though maybe tides are turning in life. But let's talk about more about you, like how you have gone through the process of launching this brand. But I would love to sort of get a nice little elevator pitch about what Yunizon is.
Yeah. Well, really, my co-founder and I, Rebecca Lay is my co-founder, and she also is a mother, and she lives out in Australia, so we kind of work all kinds of crazy weird hours and stuff, but we wanted to kind of create Yunizon. We wanted to create an eyewear brand that really is an all-inclusive eyewear brand that focuses heavily on fit. So, and we wanted to kind of have it really ingrained with the values of unity, belonging, and self-expression. So I think right now what's been happening, you know, I've been in the eyewear industry for 15 years, and I think there's always one size of sunglasses. There isn't multiple. So I think it kind of alienates a lot of people. And so when I was my time at Luxottica, before I left, we were really focusing on different fits, and they were using kind of these buckets, Asian fit, universal fit, this is more like a European fit. But I think with the modern day, we have such a different cross group of people. So there isn't just one group that can benefit from Asian fit, you know, and so I think sometimes just saying Asian fit could be a deterrent for some people because they feel, well, I'm not Asian, I wouldn't have those problems. But there's people with low nose bridges, there's people with high cheekbones, and it doesn't really matter what race you are.
When did that click for you? Like that sort of white space?
Definitely when I was working there, because it like really, I mean, I know even in my family, I was somebody with a very narrow head, and Esteban, my husband, has a very wide head. So I can't fit into anything. And then he couldn't fit into anything, and yet we had the opposite problems. And so I never had nose bridge problems, but there's ways of kind of improving the nose bridge that would fit more people. So I feel like what's been happening is you have an eyewear, these like large groups, you know, like you have the Luxotticas and the Safilos, and they control the fit and styling of the majority of high-end eyewear. So there wasn't diversity, and so there wasn't there was no brands kind of catering to diversity. So we kind of, that was like our real idea, and it stems originally from my co-founder was very involved in EDM and EDM festivals, which is electronic dance music. And so those festivals really brought people together, and they just really felt united. And we said, what is it about that? So we just wanted to kind of, from that, That's where we kind of created our values. We kind of tried to boil down what is it that people love about these festivals? What do people love about music? And so our brand is also trying to do collaborations with different artists, different musicians, and, you know, so far it's been building. But, you know, that I think that's really important kind of to have this diversity or people expressing themselves and people, you know, it's the brand is more than just the product. And in addition, you know, kind of because the values are so important to us, we also feel like you need a balanced state of mind to kind of embrace all these values. So we also donate a portion of all of the proceeds to NAMI, which is the National Alliance of Mental Illness. So we kind of
why did that?
Well, again, where did it come from?
Yeah.
We also kind of looked and the people that were, we were just kind of using like these festivals as like a cross section of people. Like, what are some of the common problems that these people are having? And it was, you know, maybe drug use, drug abuse, suicide. A lot of them just felt like, and from the suicide kind of could happen because they just didn't feel like they belonged anywhere. And sometimes these festivals were the only place where they felt like they could belong. But all these problems, there's lots of different problems, but it all boils down to kind of mental illness. And you know, mental illness, it's not always just an illness. You know, people think like if you're slapped with some kind of, name
for it. Right.
Yeah, we can all go through phases of having hard times or going through depression and things like that. And I mean, that's really the stem of kind of going through all that is the stem of who you are, and it builds you up into a better person. But you know, we're kind of hoping to also make a difference and kind of help people out there. Kind of it, everything, you know, it all just kept stemming. It was very organic and it all seemed to kind of fit together.
The time is so ripe, right? I think the messages of unity and racial equality and just sort of not being denied anything, that obviously it's extremely timely. So what are you doing to promote your brand, you know, while also being aware of the shift and the change that we've experienced?
Well, I mean, I feel like we're kind of already aligned and we're set for it. So as the things change, you know, I feel like we don't necessarily have to change much. We just have to kind of keep going and make it more obvious. So like for our Instagram, for instance, you know, we had a photo shoot in January and we tried to get diverse models, you know, and I think, you know, so that really different people can understand our message. So there's lots of different people. But not only that, it's Pride Month as well coming up, which, we've been working with different influencers that are transgender. And they're going to be like promoting us on their Instagram as well. And so we're kind of looking for like pockets of people that are really interesting. And it's not to say that they have to be so big, but that really kind of make a difference in their community. So whether people look to them. And so we're looking to partner with them. We're also doing partnership with different brands and collaborations. So there's, a brand right now that we're planning on doing our next shoot with that does a clothing line. They're from the Netherlands, but originally Greek, but they actually sell here in Williamsburg at a store. And so we're going to do like a collaboration of some of their clothing with some of the different models so that they're really promoting this gender neutrality as well. So we're doing, you know, things like that to kind of really drive it home, our message. So I think we'll just continue to find interesting people in it, it's, and kind of grow and build with them and help promote them. I think we're just trying to look and build with people and bring other people up as well. Giving
it seems support. As though, you know, like my effort in this little connecting is just sort of like, obviously starting with a small circle of people that I know and that I feel really close to that are doing something interesting with their life, and obviously having the ripple effect and sort of the connecting circles and reaching far out, which is a very organic and methodical, slow sort of process. And I think what's really nice to see from what you guys are doing is the collaborative effort is what's going to get you to the next level. And it's like, not only are you building your own business, but you're also amplifying other voices, raising awareness. So there's all these like different facets to your business, which are really lovely, especially now. I think that I, you know, everybody's playing catch up in the sense of like, oh, you know, I need to be inclusive and I need to do this. And yet like your business is built with the, as a fundamental base of diversity, inclusion, you know, gender neutrality, you know, collaboration. There's just such like, nice openness to what Yunizon does.
Yunizon is just, we wanted to something unifying, so we took the uni, like you and I, and we kind of just started looking into what words have that in it, what means unifying, and Yunizon is really what stuck, because I mean we're so ingrained in music, and Yunizon itself, like the word is just kind of, you know, all sound all together making harmony.
Well, thank you for sharing about Yunizon. Yes, sure. Now, and then before we end our conversation, I would love for you to share anything, anything actually at the moment. People have shared things like, you know, music, books, obviously there's like all kinds of books circling around, you know, quotes, like people. Is there anything that you were like, this touched me in a certain way, I want you to know about it?
Well, yeah, so I love music and stuff. I listen just as diverse as my jewelry collection is, so is my music collection, and I've always been really into all kinds of music. So I've always liked the song from Living Color, "The Cult of Personality," and it was written in 1987 in like a Brooklyn loft, and it's kind of, I mean, it's 33 years ago, but I feel like people need to listen to that song, because it really, what it talks about is not just the, it goes beyond the idea of what's good and bad, but it's what do good and bad have in common. And also the idea of celebrities in politics.
Oh.
It's actually kind of really relevant right now. And this was written 33 years ago. And I know.
What do you see? The cult of personality.
And it's just a very interesting, I mean, honestly, like who wrote anything in the 80s that's worth, like, that's really sticking or that's deep? I mean, there was a few bands, but I don't know.
How did that come? Like, when did you think of that?
I don't know. I just was like, kind of when I was like trolling through my music and it came up and I was like, wait a second. Because it always used to be one that I like to belt out. You know, it's like when you're driving in your car, like it's a great one to scream. So it just, sometimes you listen to things and you don't even pay attention to the lyrics and everything, but it was like one of those, like, I was like, wait a second.
Well, thank you so much. I mean, we have a friendship, a very longstanding friendship, but it's been truly a pleasure to, I don't know, to witness you sort of like your life unfolding in front of my eyes and being a part of everything, including Esteban and Natalia and your business. And I don't know, it's just such a, it's a precious gift to have some like really amazing friends, and but the fact that we can also talk about jewelry. And here she is. Oh my God, you have